Hello everyone, welcome to all of you. So in last lecture we were discussing about diversity in the living organism. In this lecture we are going to discuss about taxonomic categories. So first I want you to make sure about some terminology, like what does mean by taxonomic categories, what does mean by unit of classification, what is mean by rank of categories. So whenever you are arranging or you are classifying things, so you are using some group, it is known as a category. And because you are using this category for the taxonomic purpose, so that's the reason it is known as a taxonomic categories. And when it will form one chain of classification, so it will become hierarchy of the taxonomy. And each and every category falls in this group or species, genus. Actually, they are rank or unit of the classification. Without unit of classification, you cannot classify the things. That's the reason these all things are unit of classification also. See this species, genus, family, order. We'll see these all things in detail in just a few seconds. I want you to pause this video and see this basic difference between taxonomic categories of for plant and for animal. There is minor difference. It is here. For animal you will use word phylum, and for plant you will use word division. So how you will classify the animal or plant or identify? So you need some character, like similarities and dissimilarities, on the basis of which you will classify the things. So let's move on to the first category. It is a species. So what does mean by species? Species, it is group of individual organism with fundamental similarities. For example, this is Asiatic lion and this is African lion. And what happened if this is belong from the Asia continent and this is belong from the Africa? But it is lion, right? They are the lion. And there are so many varieties in mango also, but what happened again? They all are mango. So Mangifera indica, mango, Solanum tuberosum, Potato, Panthera leo. So in this, Mangifera, Solanum and Panthera representing genus, and Indica, tuberosum and leo represent species or specific epithet. So you can see here also, Panthera has a two species, Tigris and leo. Solanum has a three species, tuberosum, nigrum and melongena. Why? Because they are sharing common characteristic of their fruit shape. Because they have a same fruit shape, that's the reason they all falls under one genus, and it is Solanum. And here you can see also lion, this lion and tiger have some fundamental similarities, some basic similarities. That's the reason we cannot put together in one species, but we can put this in one genus. So species, it is separate for both this animal. Now let's move on to the another category. It is genus. So what does it mean? Genus, it is group of related species which has a more character in common in comparison to species of the other genera. For example, see, we cannot put this Pardus, Tigris and Leo in one species. So Panthera has a three species, it is Pardus, Tigris and Leo. Because they are sharing some similarities between them, that's the reason they all are falls under one category, and it is genus. One genus, it is Panthera. But we cannot put this cat under this, you know, under this Panthera genus. Why? Because there is so many dissimilarities we can find between these two animals. That's the reason cat has a separate genus, and it is known as a Felis. So this Felis, it is genus. But again, Panthera and Felis will come under in one family, and it is Felidae. See here. So what mean by family? It is group of related genera or group. For example, you can see here, this Felis and Panthera falls under one family, it is Felidae. But we cannot put this dog in this Felidae family. Why? Because dog has a so many dissimilarities with this rest of the animals. That's the reason dog has a separate family, and it is Canidae. But again, this Canidae and Felidae will falls under same order. we'll see later on. See here, Solanaceae. Because this, Solanum tuberosum, Solanum nigrum, and Solanum melongena, they all are sharing common character, and it is spherical shape of their fruits. That's the reason this all things falls under one family, and it is Solanaceae. See, this is Petunia, this is Datura. So they have a spherical shape of fruit. Now let's move on to the another category, and it is order. So what mean by order? So you can say order, it is group of family. See here, Canidae and Felidae. Actually, we cannot put dog in this Felidae. That's the reason dog has a separate family, and it is Canidae. So Canidae and Felidae, because they are carnivorous animal, that's the reason they falls under one category or one order, and it is Carnivora. And same case here, Convolvulaceae and Solanaceae, because of their flower characteristic, they are sharing some common character or common some similarities. That's the reason the Convolvulaceae and Solanaceae will put under this polyammonials order. Now see what mean by class. You can say class, it is group of order, or this category included related order. For example, primata. See here, we all are prime animal. Why? Because see, this monkey, gorilla, gibbon, and even we people are prime animal. Prime means, you know, main. So we all falls under one common order, and it is primata. And because this primata and carnivora have some similar characteristics, and it is about mammary gland, because we all have a mammary gland. For example, this dog has a mammary gland, cat, pardus, tigris, leo, all has a mammary gland. That's the reason they all falls under one class, and it is mammals. So this is order, this is family, genus, species. Now let's move on to the another category, it is phylum. So what mean by phylum? So phylum, it is group of order, you can say. For example, fish, amphibia, reptiles, bird, all are falls under one phylum. See here, chordata, it is phylum. So you can say that amphibia, reptile, aves, mammalia, chondrichthyes, osteichthyes, even this species, all falls under one phylum, and it is chordata. So I will explain you in detail this chart in upcoming chapter, chapter number 3, and it is animal kingdom. Now you are pretty clear about kingdom, what mean by kingdom. Actually, plant kingdom and animal kingdom both are separate. Why? Because if you want to come under this plant kingdom, so you must have a autotrophic, then and then you can come under this plant kingdom. And what special about animal? They all are heterotrophic. They are not able to produce their own food, so they are dependent on autotrophs. See this category, whenever you are going upward from species to genus, family, order, class, phylum, or division to kingdom, you will find so many dissimilarities, and you will find so many difficulties to classifying these animals whenever you are going upward. And whenever you are going downward, so you will find so many fundamental similarities between each and every group. And this is some scientific name of some animals like man, housefly, and some plant also, mango, wheat. See, for family, there will be always one suffix. It is end with AE. So hominidae, muscidae. As well as for mango, it is Anacardiaceae. So it will always end with this AE. And for order, especially in plant, in animal, it will always end with A. Primata, Diptera, Carnivora. Same as in case of plants, it will always end with ELS. A-L-E-S, ELS. For example, sapindales, poels. So it will always end with else. So You can pause this video and see this scientific name of this man, housefly, mango and wheat. So from above table in 2016, NEET had asked this question. Kindly read this question and give me answer in comment box. So thank you very much for watching this video. I hope this video may be helpful to you. If you like this video, so kindly subscribe this channel for upcoming new videos and share this video with respected person. Thank you very much.